What we have here is a Utahraptor ostromaceorum. And Utahraptor, art imitating science. When Utahraptor was announced, Jurassic Park had just come out, and Jurassic Park's Velociraptor turned out to be based on an upscaled Deinonychus, another larger raptor. And the animals in the movie were even larger than Deinonychus. However, when this animal was announced, they finally found something that was as big, if not bigger, than the raptors in the movie itself. One of the most impressive components of Utahraptor is this number 2 toe bone. And you can see it here. Here's my hand for comparison. So the Velociraptor claw, very tiny in comparison to those giant claws. Just like you can see, the leg designed for speed, huge pelvis, lots of musculature. One of the things that amazes me about this tail, we're gonna go sweep down the tail. There's the sacrum, lots of muscles around that. This tail has what we call transverse processes, or I like to call them caudal ribs for ontogenetic reasons. But you have muscles would have been down that whole side. And these chevrons look like a pair of skis front to back. It's actually why the name Diplodocus is named Diplodocus, for a similar shaped chevrons. You have what's called prezygapophyses. These articulate with the postzygapophysis. But because it goes so much farther past, you've got a tail that had some mobility to it. So this is not a ramrod straight tail. This is a tail that allowed it up front, it would have been very straight and stiff, but it had some motion at the end. But the very end of the tail stiffens back up. So this is an animal that could have swished its tail had it desired. One of the really interesting facts about Utahraptor, there are these hand claws, kind of up above here, are actually these foot claws. The hand claws of this particular animal are even more recurved. So this particular mount has these gorgeously hand splayed open, but the claws on the mount are actually toe claws. So it's an example of the mount was put together and information has subsequently been learned. You can see a wishbone. Let's see if I can zoom in on this. Right there. It's kind of cool to think. Imagine having this guy turkey dinner. Now, raptors typically have small grasshopper skulls. This guy, however, has a skull that is absolutely powerful. You can see the sharp teeth in it. You can see the sclerotic ring where its eye would have been inside. The big back of the jaw had a lot of muscles attached. Its teeth themselves, very sharp. This would have been one of the ultimate predators. And unlike what's popular, where dinosaurs or the raptors are thought to have been in packs, Utahraptor did not need a pack and likely did not hunt in packs.